Hi there and welcome back to Umraco Learning Base channel. My name is Isha and in today's video, we'll create a simple block list using an element type and render it on the front end. So what's a block list? Block list is a list editing property editor which uses element types to define the list item schema. The block list property editor contains blocks of content within a content node. With the block list editor, you as a developer have a lot of control over how the blocks are displayed, edited and validated. You'll also find the entire workflow for creating and updating blocks and types related to the block list editor is intuitive and easier to work with. So let's dive in. I have a project with StarterKit installed. In the settings section, I'll use the product page as a document type to define the block list editor. I've removed the features and detailed description group, which contained the nested content and grid layout respectively. The content section has content nodes predefined as part of the StarterKit installation. Let's see how this page looks on the front end. We'll go to the Info tab and click on the Publish link. Currently, we have the product photo, product name, price, description, and a buy button. Let's add a blocklist editor here. We'll go back and open the product document type from here. Now, we'll scroll down to the bottom and add a group called Product Features. To this group, we'll add a property called Product Features and select Blocklist as its editor. We'll click on Create New to set its configuration. In the Available Blocks section, we need to define the blocks. This is where the Blocklist editor configuration is a bit different from the other property editors. The list you create with the blocklist editor is based on one or more blocks. Each block is based on an element type. If we click on Add, all the document types are disabled. If I expand this folder, I have an element type that's already created. So I can either choose an existing element type or create a new one. I'll add an existing element type and now create a new element type as well. Instead of creating element types separately, we can start creating it from here directly by clicking on the Create New Element Type button. We'll give our element type a name. Let's call it Product Features and add an icon to it. We'll now add a group called Feature Details and a property called Feature Name and a text string as its editor. Let's submit this property and add another property called Feature Description and add a text area as its editor. We'll click Save and Close. We are now presented with the block configuration options. Each block has individual configuration to allow for maximum flexibility and has several features to customize the editing experience. There are four main areas of configuration: editor appearance, data models, catalog appearance, and advanced. In the editor appearance, you can see how the block appears when accessed in the content section. You can customize the label for a block, and this can be a static label or a dynamic label based on AngularJS expressions. I want to display feature name as the label of my block, and so I've added my property alias here. Next, you can override the AngularJS view for the block presentation. Use this to make a more visual presentation of the block, or even make your own editing experience by adding your own AngularJS controller to the view. We'll use the setting in the next video. Next, you can pick your own style sheet for this block. By adding a style sheet, you override the back office styles for the view of this block. And finally, you can set the size for the content editor overlay for editing the block. Moving on to data models. Data models hold the element types that are used for a block. The content model is the element type for the block content. We have product features element type which we just created. Additionally, if you want, you can add an element type for the settings model as well. The settings model will show up as settings in the content section and is available both for inline and overlay editing. We'll look at this in the next video as well. If a model is selected here, you can use this as a shortcut to edit the element type. In the catalog appearance, these properties refer to how the block is presented in the block catalog. The catalog is what you see when you choose a block to add to a list in the available block section. Here, you can customize colors on the icon, text, and background. You can even choose an SVG or thumbnail if you want to give your editors a preview of what the block looks like. Finally, in the advanced section, this property is relevant when you work with custom views. So, if you have made a custom view that enables you to edit the content part of a block and you're using default editing mode, you might want to hide the content editor from the block editor overlay. Let's submit this configuration and we have a block added here. We also have a couple of settings for the block list property editor listed here. In the amount field, you can set the minimum or maximum number of blocks that should be allowed in the list. If you enable the live editing mode, you can view changes as you type in editor overlays for updated custom views or labels using custom expression. Enabling inline editing mode uses the inline editor as the default block view. And at the end, we have the property editor width, which overrides the width of the property editor. Let's submit the settings. Our block list is now added to the document type. We'll save the document type and go to the content section and add some content to it. I'll select add content and select quote block and add a quote to it. Cool. I'll now add my next block. I'll select product features and give it a name and description. Cool. As you can see, the feature name is listed as the label of the block. Cool. I'll save and publish the content node and let's render this on the front end. In our documentation, you can find detailed instructions on how to render data from each of the available property editors in Umbraco. I'll leave the documentation link in the description of this video. Let's take a look at the documentation for Blocklist Editor. This article contains information and snippets for Blocklist Editor. Since we are using Models Builder, we'll use this snippet here. The article further mentions to make this code work, we need to create a partial view for each block. So let's do as it says. We'll go to the Settings section. In the Templates folder, we'll go to the Product Template and I'll paste the snippet here. And replace the property type alias with my alias. Cool, I'll save the template and move on to the partial view folder. In the partial views folder, within the blocklist folder, I'll create a new folder called components. Within this folder, I'll create a new empty partial view and call it product features, which is the alias of the element type. We'll now go back to the documentation and copy the snippet we need for the partial view and paste it here. We'll make some changes to the snippet. So we'll replace the my element type alias of content with our element type, which is product features. And since we do not have settings element type yet, I'll comment this line. This code is basically accessing the properties of the contents and settings section of the block from the product features element type. Here, I'll replace the output value with our properties. So, I'll render the feature name and feature description. I'm using content since we've already declared the variable to store the content properties of the blocklist item. Cool. I'll just comment this line and save the partial view. I'll quickly create another partial view for our quote element type. Since the quote element type uses a grid, I've used the HTML helper extension to render the grid item. We now have partial views for each block, so let's go ahead and refresh the front end. And there it is, our block list is now rendered on the front end. So, in this video, we've added a block list and rendered it on the front end. In the next video, we'll look at customizing views for blocklist. So head on to the next video.